Well, grace to you and peace from our risen Lord. Christ is risen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, it will be now, and will be forever. Amen. This is the day that the Lord has made. Alleluia. I will rejoice and be glad in it. Alleluia. We gather for worship in beauty and in truth because we have faith that Jesus Christ is raised from the dead, because we have hope that the resurrection will enter in each of our lives and transform them, and because through Christ's Spirit we have come to love one another. So let us pray. Giver of new life, accept our worship, gracious God. Be present with us as miracle and mystery. Be with us as the tender hands of grace that will make our lives new. Amen. I invite you to stand as we sing our opening hymn together. And may the Lord be with you.
And also with you.
And let us pray. O God of mercy, we no longer look for Jesus among the dead, for he is alive and has become the Lord of life. Increase in our minds and hearts the risen life we share with Christ, and help us to grow as your people toward the fullness of eternal life with you. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. You may be seated. Alleluia, Christ is risen. He is risen indeed. Alleluia. That's a great word for us today, isn't it? Alleluia. This is the most important weekend that we celebrate all year, the resurrection of Jesus, and God has made it great this year by gathering us together this year. So God has made it great by gathering our musicians together. So we want to thank Morgan and John and Chris and Haley for providing music for us. God's gifted you with musical ability, and so we appreciate you sharing it with all of. Don't we appreciate that? Yeah, we appreciate that. We also appreciate the ways in which we can gather with those not in this room. So our services are on our radio this morning, our local radio station, and they're also, we're broadcasting live on Facebook and YouTube, and I guess all of those things that I don't quite understand. But let's just maybe turn to the camera's right over there in the back, and maybe we can just a shout out and hallelujah, and the people that are joining us on radio can shout with us, hallelujah. All right, one, two, three, hallelujah. All right, good morning. Good morning to you joining us online. We're thankful for our broadcast online given in memory of Robert and Winnie Giese from their daughters and their family. So thank you for that. Easter bulletins that you have in your hand are in honor of Kurt and Diane Shepwaister's grandchildren, and I think some of them are here today, and so maybe the grandchildren can wave to us and shout hallelujah. Did you know that the bulletins are given in your honor? That's pretty special, isn't it? All right. You know what? Why don't you come down here? Why don't you come down here? All of the Shepwaister kids, grandchildren, come down here. All right. The bulletins are in your honor today. You should be excited about that. You're still waking up, aren't you? All right. Great, thanks for joining me down here. Any other kids want to come down here? I mean, then I don't have to feel so lonely. Come on. Come on down here and have a seat. We're going to continue to give thanks for people that help us with our Easter services here. We want to thank Marks on Main for helping us with our flowers. And then if you turn to the inside portion of your bulletins, you'll see many of you who sponsored our flowers to beautify, to make our worship great this morning. Turn around and look at all the Easter flowers that we have here. Isn't that great? And so you have honored and memorialized your loved ones, and so we want to thank you for that, and also to thank Marks on Main, Mark and Mary, for helping us set all of our flowers out. Okay, anybody else want to come down, kids? This is great. Isn't this great? Yeah, this is great to be together. Not so great to be together. It's great to be together. Is it great to be together? Yes. All right, great to be together. All right, let's see. It's not Jesus' birthday today. It's the day that Jesus rose from the dead, but it is Joyce Fjerkenstedt's birthday today. Is she here with us? Joyce, 49 years old today. Maybe a little dyslexia there, right? But happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, Joyce. Would you stand? So would you like your kids? God bless you, Joyce, today on your birthday. I think that's all the announcements that I had written down. So, great day to be together for Easter. Wow. You know what? I might have something for you guys, being you came up here. Let me see. You know, I thought I had, is there anything open? No, nothing there. I thought I had something for you to celebrate Easter. Easter eggs. Easter eggs?
Yeah, I saw them outside.
You did not. Those Easter eggs are supposed to be hidden outside. Did you see them already?
Yeah, a whole bunch.
A whole bunch. We got to have better hiders, evidently. Who hid our Easter eggs this morning? We are going to have an Easter egg hunt. Yeah, the bunny. Yeah, that's right. The bunny hides it. Can I get by here? I got to grab something because I think there might be something. Is it, you have the Easter honey at your house? Easter honey? I thought I heard Easter honey. The Easter bunny. Look what I did find this. Yet, and we are going to go on an Easter egg hunt a little later, okay? But, I don't know, Mom and Dad's got to give you the okay after you sit quietly in church. Well, look at all these. I don't have an Easter basket for you, but I have an Easter bag for each one of you, all right? And did I drop some? That one's yours, maybe. You want to grab that one? Who would help me hand these out? Can somebody help me? Thank you. Can you help me hand? Could you help me hand those out? All right. Everybody gets an Easter bag. Everybody gets an Easter bag. Let me go grab some more. Oh, yeah, that might have fallen out of a bag. All right, who needs an Easter bag? There you go. Oh, great, isn't this good to be together? Easter bag. Everybody had an Easter bag? Here's an Easter bag for you. Anybody else need an Easter bag? All right, now all the kids want to come down to the front. Easter bag. Are we missing one right here? Everybody gets an Easter bag. Everybody. All right. In a little bit, so we're going to go. Here's an Easter bag right here. Everybody gets an Easter bag. Everybody gets an Easter bag. All right. Okay, somebody made an Easter bag for me too. Look what I got in my, what do you think is the best thing in our Easter bags? Somebody gave me this. What is that? It's a bunny. That's the bunny that hid all the Easter eggs this morning for you outside. Isn't that nice? I'm going to sleep with this tonight. Let's see what else is in my Easter bag. Oh, you know what's so fun about Easter eggs is that when you find those, there's usually little surprises inside, right? Like you can listen to like surprises, right? And then the greatest thing about Easter is chocolate. Yes, chocolate is the great thing about Easter, huh? How many of you like chocolate? I do too. Great thing about Easter, and then you never know when you open these up. What do you think's in this one? What's in this one? Do you think it's pennies? I'm hoping it's quarters. Oh, pennies. All right. Okay. Yeah, so let's see if I got another one here that it's getting money for Easter. How about this one? That's great. How about this one? What do you think's in here? I don't know. Somebody put it in my Easter basket. It's a golf ball. I got an Easter basket. Wow, that's great. Golfing is great. Easter's great. Let's see. There's one more thing in here. Let's open this up, shall we? Do you have something like this in your? It kind of looks like an Easter egg. Just pull this one out, please. Pull this one out. Well, there's here. You can have mine. Does everybody have one like that? I'm telling you this. This is the greatest thing about Easter. Let's open it up together. Well, some of you already did. That's okay. What did you find inside? It's the cross, right? So let me tell you a little story. We remember that Jesus died on the cross, right? And so all of Jesus' friends went to the tomb in the morning to find Jesus, and they opened the stone of the front of the tomb, and they opened it up, and Jesus wasn't on the cross, and Jesus wasn't in the tomb. Jesus was empty because Jesus is with us. God raised Jesus from the dead, so it says right here on this egg, He is risen. Can you say that again? He is risen. Jesus is risen. Can you say that? Jesus is risen. So he's not in the tomb anymore. He's not dead, but he lives with us. And that's the greatest thing about Easter, is that Jesus is here with us now. And that's something to really shout and celebrate and say alleluia. Can you say alleluia really loud?
Alleluia.
Can you say it louder?
Alleluia.
Can you say it louder?
Alleluia.
All right. Now, you go, yeah, that was fun. You go, you remember that Jesus is with you, and you go back to your moms and dads, and I want you to tell them alleluia, all right? Tell them alleluia, Jesus is risen. Thanks for coming down. We will have bags in the back of the church, so if you want to use these for our Easter egg hunt after worship, you're welcome to do that as well. So they'll be in the back of the church, you can pick some up. So in case we miss somebody. Is this your bag? Okay, all right. And Patty Mork is our lector this morning. Here's a Easter bag for you.
Good morning. Our first lesson today is from Psalm 118, verses 1 through 2, 14 through 24. Oh, give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His steadfast love endures forever. Let Israel say, his steadfast love endures forever. The Lord is my strength and my might. He has become my salvation. There are glad songs of victory in the tents of the righteous. The right hand of the Lord does valiantly. The right hand of the Lord is exalted. The right hand of the Lord does valiantly. I shall not die, but I shall live and recount the deeds of the Lord. The Lord has punished me severely, but he did not give me over to death. Open to me the gates of righteousness, that I may enter through them and give thanks to the Lord. This is the gate of the Lord. The righteous shall enter through it. I thank you that you have answered me and have become my salvation. The stone that the builders rejected has become the chief cornerstone. This is the Lord's doing. It is marvelous in our eyes. This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. The second lesson is from 1 Corinthians, verses 1 through 11. Now I would remind you, brothers and sisters, of the good news that I proclaimed to you, which you in turn received, in which also you stand, through which also you are being saved, if you hold firmly to the message that I proclaimed to you, unless you have come to believe in vain. For I handed on to you as of first importance what I in turn had received, that Christ died for our sins in accordance with the Scriptures, and that he was buried, and that he was raised on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures, and that he appeared to Cephas, then to the 12. Then he appeared to more than 500 brothers and sisters at one time, most of whom are still alive, though some have died. Then he appeared to James, then to all the apostles. Last of all, as to one untimely born, he appeared also to me, for I am the least of the apostles, unfit to be called an apostle, because I persecuted the church of God. But by the grace of God, I am what I am, and his grace toward me has not been in vain. On the contrary, I worked harder than any of them, though it was not I, but the grace of God that is with me. Whether then it was I or they, so we proclaim, and so you have come to believe. The word of the Lord.
There's a peace I've come to know, though my heart heart and flesh may fail, there's an anchor for my soul. I can say it is well. Jesus has overcome, and the grave is overwhelmed. The victory is won. He is risen from the dead, and I will rise when he calls my name. No more sorrow. No more pain, I will rise on eagle's wings before my God, fall on my knees and rise. I will rise. There's a day that's drawing in when this darkness breaks to light and the shadows disappear, and my face shall be my eyes. Jesus has overcome, and the grave is overwhelmed. The victory is won.
And if you'd stand with me for the reading of the Holy Gospel on this Easter Sunday. Reading is from the Gospel of Mark, the 16th chapter. Glory to you, O Lord. When the Sabbath was over, Mary Magdalene and Mary, the mother of James, and Salome bought spices so they might go and anoint Jesus. And very early on the first day of the week, when the sun had risen, they went to the tomb. They had been saying to one another, "Who will roll away the stone for us from the entrance to the tomb?" And when they looked up, they saw that the stone, which was very large, had already been rolled back. And as they entered the tomb, they saw a young man dressed in a white robe sitting on the right side, and they were alarmed. But he said to them, "Do not be alarmed. You are looking for Jesus of Nazareth, who was crucified. He has been raised. He is not here. Look, there is the place where they laid him. But go, tell his disciples and Peter that he is going ahead of you to Galilee. There you will see him just as he told you." So they went out and fled from the tomb, for terror and amazement had seized them, and they said nothing to anyone, for they were afraid. This is the gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. And you may be seated.
Gives. I know
Well, I want to say good morning to everyone in this room once again. Good morning, and I want to say good morning to everybody who's not in this room but are gathered in rooms around our community. Good morning. I don't think we've overbooked this flight too badly, right? There's plenty of room for everybody. We got everybody in the sanctuary, so that was our goal of ours. We didn't want to have to turn anybody away or have anybody sit in the basement. You know, when you gathered at home, you know, there wasn't room at the table, right? You had to go sit in the basement and at the card table, right? Well, we don't have to do that today. I think we were able to accommodate everybody. So, just want to show my appreciation for you being here and for you joining us online. We will be celebrating the sacrament of Holy Communion later in the service, and we'll be using these prepackaged kits of Holy Communion. So, if you're at home and you want to celebrate communion with us, now is your time. If you want to go grab some juice and some bread, you can celebrate and know of Christ's presence with you as well. But we're going to celebrate this communion with these. And just a little warning for you. These aren't the easiest to open. So warning sounds like it's a dangerous thing. Communion isn't a dangerous thing. Communion is a blessing. But these are sometimes difficult. So when we get ready to have communion, my little advice to you is to take the clear plastic, grab the clear plastic on the very top from that tab, the plastic that's got the writing on it. Just grab that plastic. Yeah, take it out and look at it. And if you didn't get one, you know, we've got them in our baskets. We've got gluten packages too for those of you who are gluten intolerant. So, but you grab the clear plastic with the writing on it first, and pull that out, and that will open up the bread for you. And then what you can do is you can kind of crack the side plastic open and then pull the foil back, and that will open the juice for you. And if your neighbor is struggling with it, don't laugh at them. Don't poke fun at them. You know, just turn to them and help them, all right? Because just earlier, this week, it took me about 3 minutes to open one of these myself. So I'm just giving you fair warning, but it's good to good to be able to be together to celebrate. We do wish you a very blessed Easter. Whether you're a regular worship with us or if you're visiting as family, you are God's guests here on this Easter Sunday. And I just want to say that last year was such a different Easter. I mean, we all experienced something knew that we had never experienced before last Easter, and at least I had never preached on Easter Sunday about an empty tomb to an empty room, but that was last year. Last year, our church was literally in thousands of locations for Easter all around the country, and we still have many of you that are worshiping with us online. So let's remember that, and let's say Happy Easter to them, shall we? I know you said good morning to them, but let's say Happy Easter to them as well so they feel part of our worship. Go ahead, turn to the camera and say Happy Easter. Happy Easter. All right, there we go. So we're doing the best that we can to keep it as safe for everyone, the best that we can, and we're just honored that you're with us. I can't think of a better day to talk about what we're going to talk about. So what's the one word that would best express our response to the message of Easter? What would be the one word that would express the idea of the resurrection for us? Now, we've learned a lot of new words this past year, haven't we? This past year, we've learned words like COVID-19 and social distancing and flattening the curve and the 6-foot bubble and quarantine. You learned that word, quarantine? That was another word we learned. The group of people you were blessed living with or stuck living with, that was your quarantine, right? Here is another one, WFH, working from home. Working from home. Those of you working from home every day, you changed from your night pajamas into your day pajamas, and it was just like back and forth every day. Here's another word, Zoom calls or Zoom meetings. There are two kinds of people when it comes to Zoom: those who won't stop sending Zoom invites, and people who can't stand people who won't stop sending Zoom invites. And then all the etiquette that goes along with Zoom calling, mic muting, very important. That's another thing that we learned about this year, important stuff. But here's the thing. Underneath all of the changes, and between all the challenges, between all of the headlines and all the heartaches, I think one word is stuck out for most of us, and that is the word no, right? We have lived with the word no for a long time. No in-person worship, no fellowship, no travel, no large gatherings, no eating at restaurants, no sport fans, no opera, no movie theaters, no in-person school, no singing, no seeing your extended family, no hugging, no birthday parties, no shaking hands, no anniversary celebrations, no, 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 no. Think of that power of that word no that we have had to live with in our minds. Think of how this little word has affected our memory, has affected our feelings, our emotions, our sleep, our appetites, our ability to experience happiness and satisfaction. Now, we all have to learn how to say no and how to receive no. I get that, especially as we make space in our lives for God. I get that. But you cannot live on a full diet of no. You just can't do it. It kills the spirit. It deadens the soul. But now we have Easter. Now we have Easter. And you know what? Before there was even a church, there was an altar guild. And early on Sunday, the ladies gathered the necessary supplies to do religion right. They rose early to honor Jesus by anointing his body properly as soon as the Sabbath was over and there was enough light to see what they were doing. When death had given them a no, God surprised that first altar guild with another word: yes. I wonder if that first altar guild, those ladies, were ready for that word yes. I wonder if we are ready for that word yes. I wonder if you are ready for that word yes. At Easter, we turn to that word yes. Today, we turn to God's yes. You and I, we were made for yes, not for no. So at Easter, God said yes to life. No to death, but yes to life. And on Sunday, you go to the pandemic tomb because you had nowhere else to go. But now the tomb is empty and the stone that had blocked it had been rolled away. Do not be alarmed. He has been raised. He is not here. God said yes to life because no deadens the soul and kills the spirit. We were made for yes. When you love somebody, part of what happens is that you just want to say yes to them. If a parent and a child relationship is working right, and a lot of you have experienced this, I know when a kid comes to a parent and says, "Hey, can I do this? Can I go on this adventure? Can I have permission? Can we do this together? Can I have this thing that my heart desires?" A parent loves to say yes. Yes. A parent loves to say yes. You might have to say no sometimes, but you love saying yes. If a friend comes to you, "Could we spend some time together?" If a friend comes to you, could I tell you this secret that I've never told anybody else? Could I share this burden with you? Friends love to say yes to one another. They love to say yes. And, you know, when you fall in love with somebody, oh my goodness, even if you can't dance, if you ask somebody to dance with you for the first time, oh my goodness, and they say yes, oh my goodness, oh my goodness. And then you ask somebody to marry you and they say yes, oh my goodness. When there's somebody who has a yes in their heart for you, they love to encourage you. They love for you to grow. They love for you to say yes because they love you so much that they want you to be at your best. And yes always makes your best. Easter for us seals all of the promises that God has made for us in the resurrection of Christ. All the promises God has made for us. All the promises. How many promises do you think God has made for us? Just in the Bible, by one count, there are 7,457 promises God has made. Not many of them, not even most of them, every one of them is yes in Jesus Christ. God has a yes in God's heart for you. Whatever your life is like right now, whatever the circumstances are for you, your mother may have said no. Your father may have said no. Your kids may say no. Your boss may say no. Your therapist may say no. Your coach may say no. The IRS worker may say no to you. Your dog may say no to you. Your cat will say no to you. That college may say no. That job, that company may say no. That guy may say no. That girl may say no. But all of God's promises, 7,457, are yes in Jesus Christ. All of those promises and counting are yes in Jesus Christ. God, will you save me? Yes. God, will you forgive me? Yes. God, will you encourage me? Yes. God, will you give me a new start? Yes. God, will you give me a new day? Yes. God, will you give me strength? Yes. God, will you give me guidance? Yes. God, will you give me wisdom because I don't know what to do? Yes. God, will you give me the ability to forgive this other person? Yes. God, will you be with me every day of my life until I die? Yes. And God, after I die, will you grant me life eternal and make me part of a tremendously creative team effort under an unimaginably splendid leadership on an unconceivably vast scale with ever-increasing cycles of productivity and enjoyment, which is, as Scripture declares, eye has not seen, nor ear heard, nor the human heart conceived, what God has prepared for those who love God. And God says, yes, yes, yes. God says yes. All of God's promises are yes in Christ Jesus. And that's the yes that you are invited to live in each and every day. At Easter, the resurrection of Christ, there's the yes God says to us. But there can be this Easter, the yes that you say back to God. Of all the new words that we learned this past year, there is another ancient word in the Hebrew language, and it is the word for yes, and the word is amen. 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 You could translate it, so be it, or that's just the way we want it to be. Amen. It's our yes to God's yes. Amen. Now, unfortunately, a lot of you already know this word, amen. And it's become kind of a churchy word. It's become kind of a pious word, kind of a cliche word, and people kind of get tired of it sometimes. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. But it's our yes to God's yes. It's your yes to God's yes. On Easter, we're used to saying Christ is risen, and then everybody shouts, He is risen indeed, hallelujah. But maybe we could just say yes. Maybe we could just say amen. When I was a kid, my closest friend went to the Baptist church in town. They used to have this little church, but a lot of people in that church would shout amen all the time during the service. And they would all sit together kind of in one area of the church. It was kind of like the amen corner. And that was for people who would get so fired up about how good God was and about how fabulous it was to live in the promises of God that sometimes they just couldn't hold it in, right, during the service, and then they would just blow. Amen. They say amen together. In Jesus' day in Israel, they loved this word amen. It was kind of a yes on steroids. Amen. Amen. It wasn't just affirmative. It was amen. It was for thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory. Amen. But we're a Lutheran church. So we don't have an amen corner. We're more like going to a high-class auction where you just kind of give a subtle nod once in a while. Kind of raise your eyebrow once in a while. Put me down for that. But back in Jesus' day, that word amen was a fabulous word because all God's promises were yes in Jesus Christ. Therefore, He makes our lives great. Therefore, He makes our lives new every day. With all the words that you have had to learn this past year, let's not forget to say our yes to God, for God's yes to us. Amen?
Amen?
Amen.
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 Let's stand and confess our faith together. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, He rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. What?
Amen.
What?
Amen.
As we delight in God's resurrecting love, let us share the peace of the Lord. The peace of the Lord be with you always. And then if you want to make a sign of the peace for those around you, if you're with your family units, offer a hug, a handshake, or whatever is appropriate for you, or a wave to somebody across the church. Now it's time to take out our prepackaged communion kits and prepare those. Just a reminder again, there is gluten-free options in the back of the church in little baggies. But let's bow our heads. Blessed are You, O Lord our God, maker of all things. Through Your goodness, You have blessed us with these gifts. With them, we offer ourselves to Your service and dedicate our lives to the care and redemption of all that You have made for the sake of Him who gave Himself for us, Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. This is our Passover feast when Christ, the true Lamb, is slain, whose blood consecrates the homes of all believers. This is the day when Christians everywhere are washed clean of sin, freed for service, and restored to grace and grow together in holiness. This is the day when Jesus Christ broke the chains of death and rose triumphant from the grave. You loved the world so much that you sent your only Son to bring us life eternal. Dying, he destroyed our death. Alleluia. Rising, he restored our life. Alleluia. And so with the church on earth, we join together with the faithful of every time and place, with the choirs of angels and the whole creation in the eternal hymn. And so now we remember together in the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread and gave thanks and broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat, this is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup and gave thanks and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." Lord, lead us into your kingdom and teach us always to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. And we receive the gift of Christ in Holy Communion. The disciples came to know the risen Christ as they broke bread together. And Christ still desires that we come to know him through the bread and wine of the Lord's Supper. So welcome to the feast. And I'll invite you to take your communion wafer now, and with these words you can take and eat. Christ said, "This is my body given for you. Take and eat." And then the cup of wine. Jesus says, "This is my blood shed for you. Take and drink." And now may the God of peace, who brought again from the dead our Lord Jesus Christ, the great shepherd of the sheep, by the blood of the everlasting covenant, equip you with everything good, that you may do his will, working in you that which is well-pleasing in his sight, through Jesus Christ, to whom be glory forever and ever. Amen. And we pray together our post-communion prayer as it is printed in our bulletins. Before we do that, let me remind you that there are baskets also for you to place your empty cup in as well. They're placed around you. just so you're aware of that. Let us pray. Grant, Lord Jesus Christ, that the ears which have heard the voice of your songs may be closed to the voice of dispute, that the eyes which have seen your great love may also behold your blessed hope, that the tongues which have sung your praise may speak the truth in love, that the feet which have walked in your courts may walk in the light of Christ, and that the bodies which have received your living body may be restored in newness of life. Now may the loving power of God, which raised Jesus to new life, strengthen you in hope, enrich you with his love, and fill you with joy in the faith. And you can do better than that. Amen. 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 Go in peace to love and serve the risen Lord. Thanks be to God.